Hi guys, I'm back with a new video, and this is a video about one of the Cynthia's. I was sort of disappointed in how things went with Sam Sayers, and for some odd reason they turned the whole Sam Sayers situation into a money-making machine or something. I don't know what's going on, but doesn't really matter anymore. Sam's family rejects all help from psychics and mediums and denies all clues and information. So it is what it is, and I can't do anything about it. But I was contacted by somebody that works on behalf of one of the Cynthia's, and there was a little bit of a confusion also on my side. Because while I was searching for Sam and trying to gather information and see where she was, I found another Cynthia, and I have a feeling that she passed away. But this is what happens if you work with lost and missing people or children that are missing or what have you. One pops up, and the other, and another, and things keep going for some odd reason. There seems to be some kind of telepathic, energetic connection or frequency where everybody who is lost and wants to be found is, it's like a radio. You turn on the radio and everybody who wants to listen to a certain channel finds that channel, and you can't see each other or feel each other, but you know people are listening. And that's how I think this telepathic thing works, when you start with one girl or child and another pops up and another pops up. And I had to cry because I have a napkin here just in case I start crying again. I was very cruel towards Cynthia. Last time she came forward, and I told her that she had to wait in line, but apparently it's her turn now. And somebody contacted me who does take information from mediums and psychics very serious and is waiting for clues. Now I don't have much background information. Same with Sam, I only had a name and a picture, and in this case I think I stumbled onto a picture, but I remember what I saw in the reading or scan that I did for Sam. She is not very tall. She's a mom of four children. I think they're all girls, but when children are young, I find it very difficult to see the difference between girls and boys, by the way. Especially here in the Netherlands, where boys have this thing for long hair, and every child sort of looks the same for some odd reason. So I'm not very good at this. But I think the youngest is a girl, and she misses her mom terribly. I think that it's extremely damaging to a child under the age of, I don't know how long Cynthia went missing, but we are talking about the Cynthia I saw. I don't want to do this video again, so I'm just going to ramble and just bear with me. I was looking for Sam, and I found another Cynthia, and by finding her, the Cynthia, which is the mom of four children, whispered in my ear, and I had to separate them and first work on Sam, then go to Cynthia. But the first Cynthia that's also locked in a concrete chamber, I think she died. Cynthia, however, with the mom of four children, I think she's still alive. Let me get to this a little bit later, because I have my pendulum here and my cards here. And what I wanted to do was do a healing, do another empowerment, and then talk to Cynthia. But My readings never go according to plan. I'm not sure what I saw. I don't think I saw anything, but what I saw in or heard and saw in the reading that had to do with Sam was a beautiful young woman, and I think she straightens her hair. She's very sexy, but for some odd reason, her being so shiny and sexy kept a lot of the men I think are involved away, because they want victims that aren't so alive, lively, glowing this sexual energy. They are looking for girls that are plain, mundane, not to be disrespectful, but normal girls that don't stick out. And Cynthia is beautiful, she's sexy, she's not too small, she has, I think she straightens her hair. It's thick hair. I don't know where she comes from. It looks like Colombia, Spain, can be something African in there. A little bit of a mix, genetics, mixed blood. But the most important thing I think for the family is that I felt her heart beat. I felt a heartbeat and I saw her heartbeat. So I think she is still with us. And I think she, I don't know if her youngest child, which I see, I think it's a girl. But like I said, I'm very, even though I have 7 children of my own, it's hard for me to tell under the age of 10 or something, whether it's a child is a boy or a girl or something. But I think the baby is a girl, and what I'm going to do is try talk to the baby, because, okay, I'm from the Netherlands, so bear with me. Somebody, Sam's family has no interest or whatsoever in information from provided by psychics and mediums. She did a horrible live chat about psychics and mediums, but there is somebody who is trying to find and help Cynthia that is very open and very serious about these types of things. So, like I said, I promised to do healing and empowerment and a reading, but I'm just going to combine everything, and information always comes in bits and pieces. So this is just a start. Now, Cynthia was considered to be too extravagant or too sexy or too beautiful. That's why they sort of left her alone. But I did see and feel a heartbeat, and she is there. Now, I asked for spiritual guides and teachers, and of course, there's a group of girls involved, and they all help each other. So, like I said, I was so cruel by telling Cynthia to wait and let me... but she is very loving and patient and beautiful, and she looks really, really young. Actually, she reminds me of my own daughter, who has these round cheeks and a beautiful little nose and a smile and same type of posture. So I'm very grateful that somebody is taking this information serious, and I will do my very, very best to gather as much information as possible. But the most important thing is she is not alone. There are other girls involved. African, Spanish, white, all kinds of. But like I said, she stands out because of her liveliness. And I also have this feeling that she is lasting so long or is still alive for so long. I have a feeling that she is in this group of girls for a very long time and she has seen other girls die and taken away, and for some odd reason she is smart, as in very, very, very smart. She can just cheat her way in and out of situations, and even though she stands out, she is able to make herself invisible. So she's smart, she can make herself invisible. She is very helpful to the other girls, and she also allows the other girls to help her. Now I'm starting to wonder how big this area is, but like I said, I'm from the Netherlands, and the Netherlands is quite small. But even in the Netherlands, people get missing and they disappear and are never to be found again, or are found on a completely other side of the world or something. And what I want to do is connect with Cynthia's children tonight and see if they have messages for her, their mom, so I can pass on the messages from her children to Cynthia, to make it possible for Cynthia to hear and see her children very, very clearly. Now, I have a good visual about the baby, but the baby needs help. I hope there is an aunt or a grandma, because if children are left alone by a mom for a very long time, and I have a feeling that it's been over a year, but I'm not sure, that she will have some physical and emotional, social issues when she grows up. I think the other three are doing better. They go through anger and despair and things like that. But I will ask the person who contacted me for the names of these children, so I can maybe, with permission, send them some healing too and guidance, so to get through this, whether Cynthia is found or not. Now I used Rose, and like I said, what scares me is that this group of girls seems to be bigger than I thought. Now I'm just going to see what happens if I was Cynthia alone when she disappeared, and I get a no. Was she with one man? No. Was she with two men? Yes. So there were two men, and they pretended to be sexually interested in Cynthia, and for some odd reason she fell for it or something. But the thing is, I don't have any feeling of abuse or rape or something. It has nothing to do with overpowering the women or girls involved with sex. But I do think Cynthia is smart enough to use sexuality as a tool, so to survive and escape a death sentence or being finished, or because she is still there. It's because she's smart, she's intelligent, she knows what to do, she's not freaking out, she's not in panic, or she is hungry and she is thirsty. But like I said, they help each other. I see plates with old bread and some weird type of meat. I think it's crushed pâté or something. I don't think it's pâté because it's way too expensive. More this, you have these iron cans that are sort of flat, the size of my hand. And there is meat inside, and they just crush it with a spoon, and that's put on a plate with bread, and that's shoved under some kind of wooden door. So there are no bars, it's dark. Again, concrete, dark. The walls are moist and very cold. There's a wooden door. It is made firm or strong with iron plates, but it's not like bars. They can't look outside or something. So these plates are shoved under these wooden doors, and that's what they get. I don't see any, oh, cold beans, cans with cold beans. They're not heated up or something. So that's what they are given to as for food. So I just going to check if there were two men involved, and one walked away or something. I have no idea. I see him run to a gray bus, but I've never seen a gray bus, so it should be, can't be gray. What color of buses do they have in the US? Red? Yellow? Blue? I don't know. It's a gray big bus with, and it's dark, and he's running toward the bus stop, and the bus is already there and is about to leave, but he jumps in just before the bus takes off, and I see a number 401. So maybe that's the bus stop number or part of his phone number or something, or maybe the street, I don't know, 401. When I started, I saw 369, 401, 532, but I think I will have to stick for now with the 401. One man walked away and jumped in a gray bus, and the other took Cynthia, and I can't see the vehicle, but I feel that the seat is this fake leather, so it's not real leather, it's fake leather. It looks a little bit red, dark red. There are plastic bags in the back seat, but Cynthia is thrown on the front seat, and her arm is with, how do you call this, handcuffs put on the door, so even when she jumped out, she would have been killed or rubbed over the concrete or asphalt or what have you. I see that she did try to open the door, and again the side of the inside of the door is also that fake leather. So she tried to open and then saw the street behind her flow away, because the car that she was thrown into was already driving, and she didn't dare jump out, which is understandable, of course. I don't understand what these plastic bags are doing in the back. I have no idea. There doesn't seem to be anything in it. There are lots of them, at least 20, 25. So there is the car, and I can only see the inside, and I can feel the inside. It's fake leather, it's dark red. The handles are shiny. There is radio. There is radio. The radio is on. I see her walk out of a pub or a wait a minute. This goes too fast. I see her walk out of a restaurant with a man, and that man jumped on a bus, a gray bus. Should be have maybe because it's dark, it looks gray. Maybe it's white. There are not many people in the bus. I think 304. So he gets into the bus, and there's somebody there. There's somebody on the other side, somewhere in the middle, and two all the way in the back. That's all I see, and that's what I see through Cynthia's eyes. So then another man grabs her on this arm and pulls her to the other side of the road, which is concrete. Why is everything concrete in the United States? That's so weird. I don't understand. Should it be? I don't know. Traffic light is on red, which doesn't matter. He pulls her in the car, locks the handcuffs. He starts driving. She tries to open the door, sees how fast the car goes over the road, and decides to close the door again. Then some where along the way they stop in a alley where on one side are garage doors, big huge garage doors. They don't open like this, but they have to be pushed up. That's what I see. And there is where the light goes out. There is where they either drugged her or he drugged her. Now I'm trying to find out what the man looks like, but I think this will come to me when I wake up in the morning. So that's a thing. Then I wake up again, as because I am in Cynthia, I wake up somewhere in the wild, in a forest, and it's hilly, it's glowy. There is sand on the road, so they left the city, they went to somewhere outdoors, outside. And then everything goes dark again, and I wake up in this cellar, concrete cellar, but with wooden doors, and in it's like it's in a, not a hill. A hill is like big. This is more a, it's not a mountain, I mean. It's more a hill. It's more a, this type of area, and not with huge hills or something. But it's a sort of same concrete boxes with a wooden door that is stuck with iron plates. They shove once a day, I think, plates, white plates, plastic plates, underneath these doors with old bread that look like baguettes, and this crushed meat and these beans. So I think, well, she lost a lot of weight and she has bare feet. She stole some socks from another girl, but that girl was taken away. So she, sorry for getting so emotional, she saw a lot of girls being brought in and taken away. And I'm not sure yet how many girls she's with. I'm not sure yet how many girls were brought in and how many girls were taken out. But I think for now, this is enough. Like I said, I am waiting for pictures because I want to present Cynthia pictures of how her kids look like now. And with permission, I want to send the kids a little bit of energy, just a little bit of Reiki or angelic energies, or just pray for them. So it would help if I have pictures of the girls. I still want to say the girls, but has to be four girls. How big is the chance that there are four girls? Has to be a boy, right? I don't know, not sure. I have seven kids and six of them are girls. So she is in the middle of a nightmare, but her soul is protected. She is shielded. Well, she has nightmares all the time, which makes sense. Of course, that's not a big surprise. She is inspiring others, giving them a clear view, and is giving them hope, and letting them know that there is chance of a chance of escape and renewal. She is very busy praying to give herself hope and the other girls involved hope, steady and confident, which I already got from her. So for now, I think this is it. Like I said, I'm from the Netherlands and I have no idea what I'm talking about. All I know was that Cynthia showed herself and came forward when I was talking to the other Cynthia, who I don't feel a heartbeat, I don't see life, but Cynthia with the four children is still alive. And she is doing the best she can to help the other girls and guide the newbies into setting up a certain routine, preventing fights, things like that. Because when you're in I'm not sure if she is alone. I think she is with two other girls in her chamber. There are two, in her case, this case, Cynthia, four children, small, cheeky cheeks, beautiful face, a little bit too sexy. It's like there's a hallway, rather small. I feel a lot of water. I feel wood. I feel this wooden door. There are two of them. In one chamber, the first one, there's one girl. Cynthia is with two girls. Somewhere, another girl that's also has a darker skin tone and a blonde girl. And there are five. I don't know, one of these concrete cellars on the right. There is a last door. The fourth door is broken, so it's not being used. And what I did have to find out is how many girls there were brought in, how many girls were taken out, and if this man who took Cynthia in the car is part of the group where Sam has to deal with. But like I said, I can't do everything in one go. I have to do this with the permission of Cynthia. And while I'm talking to her, it's a telepathic thing. And I can only hope that there won't be any other girls showing up while I'm doing this. So that's it. See you next time. And I will send you this link. So it's just a start. I will meditate on this evening and work through it through the night and see what will happen and the other information that will slowly come to me. So that's it. See you next time. Bye.